Today our topic is the hydrated cyst. So in this lecture we will discuss 10 topics about hydrated cyst. So first one is the definition, next is infective agent, next is portal of entry, pathogenesis, organs of distribution, structure of hydrated cyst, clinical features, fate of the cyst, diagnosis and the last treatment. So first start with the definition. Definition of the hydrated cyst is, hydrated cyst is a structure which contains the larval form of Echinococcus species. As you can see in this picture, there it is, this is the hydrated cyst and this contains the larval cord, that is the daughter cyst, larval stage of the hydrated Echinococcus species. So next is the infective agent. Infective agent is the eggs of Echinococcus species. Next is portal of entry. This is the alimentary tract. Now discuss in the pathogenesis, that how it occurs and how it enters to the body. So first, ingested eggs of Echinococcus granulosus ingested with contaminated water, food and water. Okay, next, eggs hatch in the duodenum. Next, formation of the hexacanth embryo. Next, the hexacanth embryo will penetrate the intestinal layer. Okay, next, via the portal circulation, now it goes to the liver. Okay, via portal circulation, and then from liver it goes to the IVC via the portal vein and to heart, and then it goes to the lungs. So next organ is the lungs, where the 10-20% will get affected there. We'll discuss later. Next topic is the organ of distribution. Now here, as we told earlier, the first organ is the liver, then next is lungs. So here you can see that in liver 70%, lungs 10-20%, brain 5%, bones 1%, others, that kidney, spleen, pelvic organ, muscles 10%. Next is structure of the hydrated cyst. So here you can see that the first is cyst wall. Cyst wall contains three layers, pericyst, ectocyst and endocyst. Here you can see, this is a schematic diagram. So you can see this is the pericyst. Okay, ectocyst is the intermediate layer and this is the endocyst. Okay, now it's hydrated fluid. Hydrated fluid is contained by this hydrated, this area contains the hydrated fluid, and in nature it is colorless, clear. First is clear, colorless pleural fluid, which is highly antigenic as well as toxic. Next is daughter cyst. Daughter cyst are, these cysts are called the daughter cyst. Okay, and these are called the brood capsules. The daughter cysts are formed from the brood capsules by the process called regression. Okay, next is clinical features. So they have clinical features for two symptoms are there, basically by pressure effects and rupture of the cyst. So due to pressure effect, so liver, here you can see jaundice, lungs you can see dyspnea, and brain you can see focal epilepsy. And rupture of the cyst, due to the effect of rupture of the cyst, in liver you can see hepatic enlargement, lungs you can see chest pain, cough, dyspnea and hemoptysis. Next in kidney, hematuria, skin, allergic manifestations. Next point is about the fate of the cyst. The fate of the hydrated cyst is spontaneously, it will disappear and occurs. Next, spontaneously evacuation will occur. Hydrated cyst may die off and fluid gradually absorbed. Okay, next is calcification. Next, rupture of the pleural and peritoneal cavity, giving rise to the widespread growth of the hydrated cyst. Next is diagnosis. The most important test is Cassonis test. So Cassonis test is positive. X-ray USG, you can see presence of the cyst. CT scan, you can see the presence of the cyst. Scolex in the stool, sputum, vomitus. Next, we can do the antigen detection test, that is ELISA, coagglutination test, lattice agglutination test, and antibody detection test is indirect hemagglutination test, fluorescence antibody test, ELISA, Western blot test. Last is the treatment. So treatments, you can do the treatment by two procedures. First one is surgical and it is medical. Surgical is the surgical removal of the cyst and medical is the albendazole. So albendazole is the most common drugs used in the helminthic infection. So that's it for today. If you like this video, then please do not forget to hit the like button and please do subscribe my channel.